And welcome into Bon Appetit. Summertime is the time that we think about seafood. One of the most delicious foods you can put in your mouth is red snapper, and the place to get it is Vintage Year. Our guest today is the executive chef, Frederick Henderson. And welcome back, buddy.
Thank you.
Good to have you back.
Glad to be back.
Last week we had that crab salad. Hey, it's to die for.
Thank you.
It's wonderful. And today we're going to do a very neat twist on snapper.
That's right. We are going to sear a piece of snapper, red snapper, serve it with ratatouille made of local vegetables, and fried grit cake, and a little bit of basil pesto.
Ooh, it all sounds good.
Good.
And I love the fact that you do everything local,
mm-hmm.
or everything's Alabama. It's just you support all of our farmers and our growers.
Well, we have a good number of farmers nearby,
right.
that just need to get contact with the restaurants.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I love it. Vintage Year has always been good about that.
All right, well, let's get that fish.
Let's go.
So the first thing we'll do is we'll sear off the snapper. You need a good mm-hmm. hot pan for that, so you can get a good sear without it sticking. Put a little bit of oil in the pan.
It's extra virgin olive oil.
Extra virgin mm-hmm. olive oil.
One of the best things to cook with.
Then we'll just got a little bit of salt and pepper on the snapper.
Mm-hmm.
Put it in and let it start to sear. While we're doing that, we will cook our ratatouille. Now, I have brought...
And again, with virgin olive oil.
Again, I like to cook with virgin olive oil.
Absolutely.
It adds a nice flavor. You have to be careful about your heat.
Right.
That's right.
Right.
The flavor is very good.
Yes.
As well as it is very good for you. So for the ratatouille, I've made some already. We'll get it in this pan to warm it up.
A little bit of sizzle there.
Ratatouille is basically onions and garlic, yellow squash, zucchini,
mm-hmm.
tomatoes, eggplant, and a little bit of pepper.
Great.
Bell pepper. So we'll get that to start warm up.
It's the old flip. The old flipperooski.
I tried that one time.
That is in the pan.
And it wound up all over the floor. That was my last attempt.
Nice. Very, very pretty. And now you're going to make what?
The last thing we're going to prepare for this dish are the grit cakes that we...
A grit cake.
I prepared grits like you would for breakfast, and then you just cool them in the refrigerator till they'll congeal.
Okay.
And then you can just cut them out any size you want. I just dust them with a little bit of cornmeal, and saute them in the pan to put a little bit of crust on them and warm them up through.
What a great way to do that.
You know what Italian grits are? Polenta.
Polenta.
That's right.
Polenta.
So we've got a couple
Isn't
of these
that
going.
Nice.
I just love this.
I think our fish is ready to turn.
Yes, it is. Oop, did we do it too? Do you want me to, I'm controlling the heat over here. So you let me know when you want me to do something, okay?
So we put
it's
our fish
good.
In the oven to cook.
Okay, so this one we can turn off.
You can turn that one off.
Okay.
As our ratatouille gets hot, we'll put at the very end of it a little bit of chopped basil.
Ah.
Oh, I love that. I love that. And we still got grit cakes going.
Are these guys going to get a flip?
They
okay.
are.
We need to. Step. There you go. Very nice. Boy, those look nice.
I'm going to love
these. I'm going to give that a little flip too so our audience can take a gander at those. Is there. Is it the olive oil that's giving them more of the yellow?
Or the cornmeal.
You can use,
cornmeal.
I mean, for that matter, the cornmeal does give it the color.
Mm-hmm.
It sears with the oil. You can use butter too. A lot of people like it if you don't mind the extra fat.
Nope.
You know, it's also fun to have the stone ground cornmeal mm-hmm. and the stone ground grits.
Well, these are stone ground grits. They're from Wetumpka.
Yep.
Yeah, from
Ogie Farms.
Yeah,
that's right.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And again, local. Love it. I just love it. And I love the stone ground grits.
All right. So
we're going to.
We'll start to plate this. We'll put our grit cakes.
So there's another going off. Should I turn off the heat on the
ratatouille? You can go ahead and turn that off.
Everything's off now.
Put our grit cakes on the plate.
Ooh.
Oh, that
ratatouille.
Looks so good.
You grab that ratatouille dish right there, please.
Okay.
So that we can get a real good shot on his. There you go.
That smells so good. I wish you could smell. I wish we had smell-o-vision.
You got that right.
All right. Wow. And then we'll put our piece of fish on
Beautiful.
That is so pretty. Look at this.
Get a nice sear on the fish.
Oh.
Ooh.
And I've got a little bit of basil pesto.
Isn't that? Who would have ever thought of that?
Did you come up with this combination yourself? I bet you did.
I did.
See, that's creative cooking.
We'll put the pesto on top.
That's what I would. I would love that.
Uh-huh.
A little piece of basil for a garnish.
Mm-hmm.
And there you are.
And voila, you've got it. It's
what
the
an
vintage
artist.
Year. You're in Old Cloverdale. Open Tuesday through Saturday, 5 to 10 p.m. at night. Mm-hmm. Sunday for brunch, 10:30 to 2 o'clock in the afternoon. You take reservations.
Yes, we do.
And that's a key word in my world. Take a reservation.
Great
now,
food.
The past 2 weeks we've seen, obviously, fish dishes with the crab last week and, of course, the snapper this week. But I'm sure you have a full contingent of steaks and other
we do steak and poultry. Absolutely.
Good. The whole nine yards.
They have it all. And they have an excellent wine selection, I might add, too.
Sure.
For those of you
comes from down the street.
Who are connoisseurs. Absolutely.
That's right.
It makes it easy.
So be sure.
They can have all the wine they want.
So let's go over and have something good to eat.
That's it.
Enjoy good company. And thank you so much for being with us. And thank you, Frederick.
Thank you.
Vintage Year, we'll see you there. Thanks for being with us. We'll be right back.